we'd like to invite you to be part of a very important tradition here at Art of Problem Solving called Pizza Monday. Every Monday, we order pizza for lunch from Vinny's Pizza, and the number there is 619-445-5995. Now, I realize that you probably don't live very close to Alpine, California, can't exactly drop in for pizza, but we'd still like you to be part of this very special tradition by buying the pizza. The number again, 619-445-5995. I like sausage, pepperoni, green peppers, mushrooms, no olives, no onions, no anchovies, basically nothing that starts with a vowel. Again, Vinny's Pizza, 619-445-5995. Thank you very much. Unfortunately, Vinny's doesn't deliver, so we're going to have to go get the pizza you order us. Now, we used to drive. Now, there are six of us in the office, and we would send three people to drive. So there are lots of different ways we could choose the people. I mean, first of all, there were six ways to choose the driver. And then after we chose the driver, no matter who we chose, there's still five people left in the office. So we have five people to choose from for the shotgun seat. And then after that, there's still four people to choose from to stick in the back seat with the pizza. So in total, we'd have six times five times four ways that we could grab three of us, stick them in the car as the driver, shotgun, and back seat, and send them off to get the pizza. For example, we could have Dave drive, put Larry in the shotgun seat, and then put me in the back seat with the pizza. I like to be with the pizza. Now, I should have introduced myself, but that's me. My name's Richard Rusczyk. I think you can see it. Maybe it's there, over there, up there. I'm not sure where it is. I can't quite see. But Richard, that's me, R. So if we're going to drive, we have six times five times four ways to go get the pizza. Unfortunately, as you know, gas has gotten really expensive, so we don't drive anymore. Pizza place is close enough, we walk. And we still send three people. We pick three of the six of us to go walk down, but the difference now is the order doesn't really matter. We don't have a driver of the group, we're just a group of three people going down to get the pizza. So the big difference here, and I'm going to write it down, that's how important it is the order doesn't matter. And to give you an example of how it matters over here, this isn't the only way Dave, Larry, and I can get in the car. Well, Larry could be driving, Dave in the shotgun seat, and I'm still in the back seat eating the pizza you bought us. Or we could put Dave in the back seat and Larry in the shotgun and have me drive. Or Larry could be driving with me in the shotgun, Dave in the back seat. Or we could put Larry in the back seat with the pizza. And there are a couple ways we can do that. So we see here there are a bunch of different orders we can use to put Dave, Larry, and me in the car. In fact, we see that there are 3 times 2 times 1 orders. Because once you've picked three of us to put in the car, there are three ways to choose one of us to be the driver, and then there are two of us left to be in the shotgun seat, and then one in the back seat with the pizza, and I hope it's me. But over here when we're walking, the order doesn't matter. So when we start counting the number of ways we can pick three to send them to go get the pizza, well, we can start off the same way as before, 6 times 5 times 4. And choose the first person, there's 6 ways to choose the first person, 5 ways to choose the second, 4 ways to choose the last. But the problem here is we're overcounting. For example, Dave, Larry, and I are counted here, we're counted 6 times. And we see that over here, we're counted 3 times 2 times 1 times. And those are all different when we're driving, but when we're walking, they're all the same. So we only want to count this once over here, but 6 times 5 times 4 counts it 3 times 2 times 1 times. That's a problem. In fact, every single group of three people gets counted 3 times 2 times 1 times when we do 6 times 5 times 4. We only want to count it once. We count everything 6 times. We know how to fix that. If we've counted everything 3 times 2 times 1 times, all we have to do is divide. And then we'll count everything exactly once and only once, and that's the whole goal. Again, the whole difference between these two is when we're getting in the car, order matters. First person's the driver, next person's shotgun, next person's back seat. So these are all different when we're getting in the car. But when we're walking, they're all the same. The order doesn't matter. Now we've seen this before. We gave it a fancy name, permutation, when really it's just multiplication. We've seen this before, but this is something new. And in fact, this comes up where you're choosing from a group and order doesn't matter. This comes up so much that it has a special name. I'm going to write it down here, combination. And we're going to talk a lot more about combinations because you use these so much in counting, they become just another operation like multiplication or division, addition or subtraction. They become so common that we even have some special notation for it. And first I'll show you a couple common notations that I don't particularly like too much. Here's two notations for this. C of 6, 3, or we can write a little 6 and then a big C and then a little 3. I'm mostly showing you these just so if you see it somewhere else, you know what they're talking about. I don't like these notations. The notation I prefer is this. We use a big parentheses and we put the numbers in there, one on top of the other. And what this means is we have 6 objects and we're choosing 3 where order doesn't matter. And you hear that word I'm saying, choose, choose. That's actually how you read this. This is read 6, choose 3. I'm going to get rid of these because, well, I don't like them. And we've already seen how to compute this. We've seen how to count the number of ways to choose 3 objects out of 6 where order doesn't matter. Well, first we pretend that order does matter. The first one can be chosen in 6 ways, the next one in 5, next one in 4. Then we think, wait a second, this is overcounting because we're counting every possible group multiple times. In fact, each group of 3 is counted 3 times 2 times 1 times, so we have to divide by that so that we count each group once and only once. And now we can compute this. The 3 and the 2, that gives you 6, cancels with the 6 in the numerator, and that gives us 20 ways to choose the 3 people to go get the pizza that you're going to buy us. And that number again, just so you don't forget, is 619-445-5995. Vinny's Pizza. Thank you very much.